running around here causing havoc as usual is Mr. Trevor Boris, so let's go check in with him.
Sounds good. Let's check it out.
Thanks, guys. Well, I can't believe it's that time of year again, where people from all over the world come to Toronto to get their gay on. So let's find some crazies to talk to. Woo! Woo, Brad!
Happy Pride.
Happy Pride. You're the first person to say that to me today.
Really?
Yeah.
How long have you started?
Like 8 minutes. It didn't take you very long to get your arm around me.
No way.
I almost wore that. That would've been so awkward. Very interesting look going on here. It's like kind of cowboy meets Mrs. Santa. What do you call this look? cowboy lesbian?
I'm not a lesbian.
You're not even gay?
No.
Get out of here. This is our weekend. I'm being violated. Are you going to prom right after this?
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah. Will you be my prom date?
I will totally be your date. Oh my God, it's just like grade 12 again when I went with a girl and really wish I had a boy. Do you mind if I get in a little closer here? Is this making you uncomfortable?
No, it's good.
I don't really tend to blend very well, I've noticed.
No. I don't know if you were picking up on that sexual tension, but he totally wanted me. I feel like you should give me a little kiss.
Mwah.
Oh, yes. I've already scored. So I've gotten to talk to a lot of fun people here, but I have to say the highlight of my pride, and probably the highlight of my life, was I got to sit down and talk to the love of my life, Mr. Rufus Wainwright.
I was second row at your show on Monday, and it was fantastic.
Fine. Thank you.
I had to pay someone $200 off the internet
for
them.
Oh, Lord.
But I was there, and it was worth every penny.
Well, you're on TV, so you're rich.
No. They never really seem to want to tell the truth. So you got a song about Brandon Flowers from The Killers.
Yes, yes.
After spending a night together in Tulsa.
Yes, yes. Just to the bar. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, with nothing too spicy happened. But we were.
Well, that's disappointing.
Yeah, I mean, I would have, you know, maybe this is just an entree.
Yeah, okay.
To the relationship. Needless to say, I do find him very attractive, and he's a real kind of morose American beauty in a very Brando kind of way.
Yeah. He's very butch. Has he heard the song?
I know he's heard it. He contacted my lawyer, actually.
Really?
But just to tell my lawyer that he will be contacting me, you know, that he will be sending me an email or a phone call. Needless to say, I've heard nothing yet.
So. Okay.
So he's playing hard to get.
He's playing quiet. That's all right. I heard that Jake Gyllenhaal joined you on
yeah,
stage.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, I've got all the brazen beauties of Hollywood.
California, California, you're such a wonder that I think I'll stay.
You strike me as a real romantic kind of guy.
Yes.
So what's the most romantic thing you've done?
The cutest thing that we do at my house is that I have a very tiny apartment. It's 450 square feet. Absolutely miss
really
in New York. It's a beautiful address.
Oh, oh yes. Could you? I won't put it on TV. Just
sorry.
It'll be just for. Come on over. Not to make you feel weird, but I've totally been in love with you since my first boyfriend. And I used to always dream about how one day we would date, and then we'd fall in love, and you'd write a really nice love song about me, and then tragically it would end, and you'd write a really nasty song.
Do you really think you go to hell for having love?
Trouble.
But Trevor Boris has been getting into trouble.
Let's take a look at what he's been up to.
Thanks, guys. Well, I'm still here in the heart of the gayborhood amongst my people. You know, the weird drunk gays. Let me get in the middle, though. Come on. You don't even want me in the middle. You're like,
I do.
Come,
no,
you do?
I do want you in the middle.
Ooh, okay. Did we get that? You must be getting a lot of attention.
I'm selling these little two pride shrines.
They're dead, though. The message is, kids, if you're gay and you get married, you're going to die. My gaydar is so off.
Really? You thought I was gay?
Yeah, I thought you were like a screaming lesbian.
No.
What about you?
I'm not gay.
Don't let me down.
I'm not gay.
Oh, will you at least make out for us, though? Come on. Come on. No. Hey guys, mind if I stay with you for a second? I've been here a couple hours now, and this is easily the gayest thing I've seen today.
Well, I thought you were serious there.
If I was, would you?
Maybe.
And what about you?
Maybe.
All right, well, let's see what happens. Cue the music. Are you all gay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, you are?
We are.
Woo! Oh, he's not gay yet. He just hasn't come out yet. He's I don't want to give away the ending, but it turns out he is gay. I think I have a date. Sorry, buddy. I think
he's having trouble following the conversation.
Oh, okay, he speaks French. He can understand that I'm hitting on you right now.
Yeah, it's okay. Okay, it's better that way.
We're cheating on him right in front of him.
Are you... Okay, let's just test. Okay.
Okay, enough of these people. Let's get back to what's really important. Rufus Wainwright. Now, I think I might have creeped him out a little last time, but let's be honest, who can resist this?
Not to make you feel weird, but I've totally been in love with you since my first boyfriend. And I used to always dream about how one day we would date, and then we'd fall in love, and you'd write a really nice love song about me, and then tragically it would end, and you'd write a really nasty song.
Do you really think you go to hell for having love?
Do you have any other celebrity crushes right now?
I don't know. I'm pretty easy. I like anyone who's, you know, has a nice salary and, you know, fairly slim.
Okay. we can edit that so it really looks like he's hitting on me, right? Okay.
California.
So who in Hollywood is gay right now that's not out? Let's pull a few people out of the closet.
Oh, I don't know.
Because there's meetings, right? We all go to meetings. And...
Really?
No, I don't know.
I don't know.
Do you feel kind of like that pioneer? Do you feel like you're kind of breaking down barriers?
It's just a reality. There isn't really another artist who, you know, who started off their entire career completely open about their sexuality and was successful and was and survived, you know, and on their own terms. There's people who started off in the closet and then came out. Okay. I think it's important that I'm here now.
So maybe you are our gay messiah.
Well, I everybody always calls me the gay messiah, but I'm not. I'm Rufus the Baptist.
That's true. So if you're not, then who is our gay messiah?
Who is our gay messiah? He's about 17 now.
Okay.
And I haven't found him on any weird
That's
gay
hot.
Sites yet.
Yeah.
But I'm looking.